Okay, so to do the mates, need to define them in such a way that the final degree of freedom that is left is the only one that we want. First, let's say the scale, we just want it to rotate about the axis and not translate in any way. Similarly for these, we just want them to rotate about some axis. So to start, let's say we define this axle first. We can go and make this axle coincident with the origin of the assembly. So let's say we select the origin of the assembly, and this axle is this part. We go down here and make coincident with the origin. Now we have this option of align axis that will align all the axes with the like the planes, all the planes with the planes of the assembly, but we do not want that because we want it to rotate, and if the planes are fixed, it will not rotate about the axis. So we uncheck this and then we click OK. Now we have this fixed, but it can still move about that point, right? So now next we want to define it in a way that it stays like completely horizontal. So we can go back to this. We can select the right plane of this part and the right plane of our assembly, and we can make them either coincident or parallel. It's the same thing in this case. And then we click OK. Now what we have is that this part can just spin because the origin is fixed, so it can only spin about that origin. But then we made another constraint that made it this basically horizontal with this plane. That way the only degree of freedom is left is the rotation, that is just one of them. Similarly, next we want this, that's a bit disproportionate, but we want this to be concentric with this thing. So we can select these two parts and make them concentric, and we do not want the lock rotation because we want it to spin about the axis. And then we click OK. Similarly, we want this to be concentric with the axle. We can make it concentric. Okay, and then we want this part to be concentric with this circle and not the axle. We can select those two. Now okay, so at this point we have this concentric with the axle, but it can still translate in the horizontal direction, so we want to fix that in some way. And similarly, this is also concentric, but can again translate about the horizontal axis. That also we need to fix. And this part is concentric, but it can move up and down. See, we somehow want to fix that up and down movement, but this part also rotates with this, and that is fine because we want that to happen. So that is not an issue. So next, what we do is we can somehow like just fix this in the horizontal direction in a particular position. So let's say we go to this part. This is this one. We select the plane 3, is it? Select the plane 3 and the right plane, and let's say we make it coincident. So that way it will be coincident, but it'll still be able to rotate because these two planes can just slide over each other, right? So if we click OK, and at this point we have this the 1 degree of freedom, which that is the rotation, and it cannot translate anymore. Now next it is that we want this gear to be at a particular distance from this gear so that the teeth can merge properly, and that will basically constrain the left and right motion of this, right? So we can go to the mates. We can either select the planes, let's select one of the planes of the assembly, and then we can select this plane. Okay, so now we had an option to select one of the planes of this part, but if we do that, that will cause an error because when this part rotates, the plane rotates with it. So we cannot define the distance using that. So here we can go to the distance and we can just eyeball it. Let's say we use 50. That looks fine for now. We can change it later. So if we click OK, now we have this constraint in the horizontal direction. So the only motion that's possible is the spinning motion. Now the next part is we want this to be at a particular distance from this face. Like we cannot make this at a particular distance from the plane of the assembly. That would again cause an error because let's say we make it at a particular distance from this plane, but when it rotates, that is changing, right? So but this plane, these two planes always remain parallel to each other. So we can make it to the mates. We can select this face, and then we can select this face. Now it's coincident right now, but we want that to be a distance one. Then again, I call it, let's say 40, 50, 52, 54. That seems fine. Yeah, that is fine now. Click OK again. Now what we have is that this part is free to rotate, but it is fixed in the horizontal direction and it is concentric. And this part is at a particular distance from this face, and that stays the same no matter where we rotate it, right? So, and then finally what we have is that we want this gear to spin it up in a particular manner so that these two spin together. So first we need to align them. For that we can just hide this part, but it's easier. We can look at it at an angle and then make these two gears align properly. That looks fine. So now we need to make a special kind of a mate, that is a gear mate. So we go to that advanced mates, we use the mechanical mate, sorry. We use the gear mate, and then we have multiple options we can take. In this case, it's easy to select these faces or this edge. Let's say we select this face and this face. Now we want to define a particular ratio so that the rotation is in sync. Now the way we get that is we can multiply. So when we created these two gears, the module was the same for both of them, and the pressure angle was also the same. So basically the diameter of the gear is the module multiplied by the number of teeth. But as the module is same for the both of gears, we can just use the number of teeth as the parameter to define the ratio. So this thing has 24 teeth, so I can use 24 here, and this a smaller pinion gear has 12 teeth. So ideally that we'll have to multiply by the module to get the exact diameter, but as it's the same, that will just cancel out in the ratio. So if we, and okay, so right now we'll have to check if they rotate properly by clicking OK. If they don't, we can just always come back and click the reverse direction. So if we go back here and try and rotate them. So right now, like they're rotating fine. Let's say, yeah, they seem to be rotating fine. In case they won't, we can just go back. We can go to the mate section. We can go to the gear section, edit this, and we can just click reverse. That will just reverse the rotation. That way now we have constrained this thing, and if we get this part back, not this one, if we get this part back, we can see that when this part rotates, this gear rotates along with it, right? Because this motion is constrained and we only have the rotation one. So now what we have is that this axle can only spin, and this gear can also just spin, and this thing can spin as well as translate along with this thing. So it has multiple degrees of freedom, and this again has just back part has just 1 degree of freedom, that is the rotation one. Yeah, that's it.